गुड मॉर्निंग 10th क्लास, दिस वीडियो इज़ फॉर सब्जेक्ट केमिस्ट्री। चैप्टर इज मेटल एंड नॉन मेटल्स एंड द टॉपिक इज फॉर्मेशन एंड प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ आयनिक कंपाउंड्स। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस डिफाइन व्हाट आर आयनिक बॉन्ड्स। द केमिकल बॉन्ड्स फॉर्म्ड बाय द ट्रांसफर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स फ्रॉम वन एटम टू अनदर एटम, that is known as ionic bond. Example is given here, formation of sodium chloride. This sodium chloride is ionic compound. So let us discuss how this sodium chloride compound is formed. So we know very well the symbol of sodium is Na, and this is the its electronic configuration 2, 8 and 1. Now how many electrons are here in the valence shell? 1 electron. So sodium lose its electron and become Na positive. Yes, sodium ion. Now its electronic configuration is 2 and 8. And how many electrons are here in the outermost? 8 electron, means its octet is completed here. Yes. Next, chlorine, its atomic number is 17 and electronic configuration 2, 8 and 7. So 7 electron in its outermost shell, it need one more electron to complete its octet. So that's why we give one electron to chlorine, and chlorine become one negative chloride ion. And after gaining one electron, its electronic configuration is 2, 8 and 8. Its octet also completed after gaining one electron. So here we can say that this is the dot structure, electron dot structure for sodium. This dot is one electron. Yes, sodium has one electron in its valence shell and chlorine has 7. So 7 dots are here, 2, 4, 6 and 1, 7. The arrow shows that the electron transfer from sodium to chlorine. So we can say that in ionic compounds like NaCl, sodium, the electron which is given by the sodium is taken by the chlorine, means the sodium transfer its electron to the chlorine and there is the formation of sodium chloride. Got it? So next example we have formation of magnesium chloride. Similarly, magnesium has 2 electrons in its valence shell because its atomic number is 12 and its electronic configuration is 2, 8 and 2. Yes, so but chlorine can gain only one electron to complete its octet. So that's why we have taken here 2 chlorines and 1 magnesium. So both the electrons from the magnesium are transferred to the 2 chlorine atoms, and that's why there's formation of magnesium chloride. Yes. Third example we have formation of magnesium oxide. Now you know very well oxygen, its atomic number is 8 and its electronic configuration is 2 and 6, means it need 2 more electrons to complete its octet, and those 2 electrons are given by the magnesium because magnesium atom want to lose 2 electrons to become noble gas configuration. Yes, 2, 8 and 2. So these 2 electrons are lost by the magnesium and gained by oxygen. That's why there is formation of magnesium oxide. This is also a ionic compound. Yes. Now what are the properties of ionic compounds? Number one, ionic compounds are usually crystalline solids like NaCl, common salt. Number two, ionic compounds have high melting and boiling points. Number 3, ionic compounds are usually soluble in water. NaCl, common salt, is soluble in water, so that's why we can say that ionic compounds are soluble in water. Fourth point, ionic compounds conduct electricity when dissolved in water. If you are not dissolving in water, ionic compound does not conduct electricity. Yes, so this is the condition. When we dissolve in water, ionic compound conduct electricity. And the fifth point, ionic compounds have strong force of attractions between their ions, like Na positive and Cl negative. These are the ions of ionic compounds. Due to positive and negative charge, they have strong force of attractions between them, and we call it ionic bonds. What we call them? Ionic bonds. Clear, bachche? Thank you.